2018 Audi Q5 SUV review. The good points of Audi Q5 SUV. Build quality. Balanced handling. Impressive efficiency. Air suspension option. The bad points of Audi Q5 SUV. Evolutionary looks. Expensive options. S-tronic slow speed reactions. Despite its Samsung looks suggesting otherwise, the second generation Audi Q5 SUV will depend on different underpinnings, with A5 coupe being voluptuousness over the flanks, along with a chunkier Q7-esque grille lending an aggressive air on the front end. Depending within the model, it's also shed approximately 90 kg of heft. As before, the Q5 includes a fearsome ensemble of competitors, the BMW X3 and Mercedes-Benz GLC are vying resistant to the Audi, as the Land Rover Discovery Sport and Range Rover Evoque mount atop a wrong British assault. Further alternatives range from the Alfa Romeo Stelvio, the Lexus NX and also the evergreen Volvo XC60. Second generation Q5, precisely the same, but different. Assembled at purpose-built facility in Mexico, there's a larger degree of aluminium and high tensile steel utilized in the Q5's construction, this occasion it's both stronger and lighter, that latter aspect benefiting overall efficiency. It also cleaves the environment more effectively than any one its SUV rivals, that has a drag coefficient of 0.30, that is relatively low just for this size and shape of car. Technology and also the whole SUV sector have moved along progress since the very first Q5 appeared, using the second generation model employing lots of the benefits of the most recent features. An improved MMI multimedia interface with far more responsive voice control may be the centerpiece with the impeccably well-constructed new cabin. It now seems like it fuses the styles on the A4 and Q7, no great surprise without bad thing either. Outside you'll spot niceties including the optional LED matrix headlights that automatically adapt their beam patterns to road types and climate. But the tour de force you sense rather than see will be the adaptive air suspension. That also costs extra, but must be top of your priority list whenever you can stretch into it. By allowing the vehicle to be raised by as much as 45 mm in off-road mode, the Q5 becomes far more capable over beaten track, capable to traverse terrain that might halt models with all the standard suspension arrangement. It's never going to become a rugged go-anywhere SUV, which the Quattro Ultra all-wheel drive strategy is not permanent on 2.0-liter models and it has no approach to locking drive to every one four-wheel sees fought it, but it's more capable than you'd expect. Petrol and diesel power plants. Audi will flesh out your Q5's engine range during 2017. But from the launch there seemed to be a limited selection of one petrol and another diesel to pick from, joined in the year by a petrol-swilling SQ5 performance model. That headline-grabbing model requires just 5.4 seconds to try and do the 0.62 mph sprint, because of its 354 horsepower turbocharged 3.0-liter engine. The more mainstream power plants are fitted exclusively with all the 7-speed S-tronic dual-clutch automatic gearbox and part-time Quattro Ultra all-wheel drive, as you move the SQ5 comes with an 8-speed Tiptronic automatic. We're currently building a 190-horsepower 2.0-liter TDI Audi Q5 on our long-term fleet, so make sure you keep an eye for the page even as provide frequent updates on the it's want to live while using Q5. Familiar Audi range structure with the Q5. Don't award yourself any prizes when you guess the Q5's trim level hierarchy to adhere to the tried and tested say, Sport and S-Line format, Audi's been perfecting this place for years. The higher performance SQ5 is effectively a trim level alone. Most are anticipated to plump to the S-line version, but there's you don't need to feel shortchanged by saving some brass and going for that, say, although only 5% of buyers are anticipated to do so. You'll still get 18-inch alloy wheels, xenon headlights with LED day or running lights, leather upholstery, 3-zone climate control and keyless ignition. You'll need to go for at least the Sport 1 you fancy Saitnov and S-Line for LED headlamps, though. Audi Q5 SUV model history. January 2017, second generation Q5 on the market to order with first deliveries from April. Only 2.0-liter TFSI petrol and TDI diesel available initially, each that has a choice of, say, Sport and S-Line specifications. Standard gearbox will be the 7-speed S-tronic dual-clutch automatic. February 2017, there's a 354-horsepower 3.0-liter V6 petrol engine by having an 8-speed Tiptronic automatic for that second iteration in the Audi SQ5, offered to order cell phone June delivery. Gray exterior detailing and different bumper and grille treatment differentiated in the less powerful models. Watch the whole Audi Q5 SUV review how good this premium crossover is really. 2.0-liter petrols and diesels to the mainstream range. Petrol power for SQ5 performance version. V6 TDI due in 2017. Lower-powered models may follow. From launch, just a pair of 2.0-liter engines, one petrol, the opposite diesel, were available, but during 2017 performance with the Audi Q5 range was uplifted while using introduction in the SQ5. Efficient TDI diesel. The mainstay on the Audi range for decades now has been 2.0-liter diesels. So it's not surprising that a 190-horsepower version fitted having a 7-speed dual-clutch S-tronic automatic gearbox and part-time quattro ultra all-wheel drive is expected for being the most popular choice. Peak torque of 400 Nm is obtainable low down inside the rev range, from 1,7503 revolutions per minute, making it easier gain access to the Q5's accelerative power from low speed. An excellent option for exiting junctions or completing safe overtaking maneuvers. That power delivery feels linear with just a slight lag in the turbocharger. Top speed is 135 miles per hour, whilst the 06 2 miles per hour sprint takes 7.9 seconds, so it's hardly slow. It's also pleasantly refined. Although its quietness was accentuated with the double-glazed side windows on our test cars. Like many vehicles fitted with dual-clutch transmissions, the S-tronic can establish hesitant when pulling clear of a standstill or crawl, whilst the software has got the transmissions act together. This can verify disconcerting at roundabouts, and was more apparent inside diesel compared to TFSI petrol. You do learn they are driving around it, though, as well as most buyers this TDI would be the engine to choose. Punchier TFSI petrol motor. Audi expects approximately 40% of UK buyers to decide on the turbocharged 2.0-liter TFSI petrol power plant because of their Q5S, an area amplified by fears among London residents that extra charges may be levied against diesel-engined cars. It's also the pick on the 2.0-liter range for all those seeking to maximize performance instead of lower their running costs. 252 horsepower and 370 Nm of torque from 1,6004.500 revolutions per minute ensures it's an incredibly flexible performer, gathering momentum impressively and progressively. Audi quotes a highly regarded speed of 147 miles per hour as well as a hot hatch-like 06 2 miles per hour use of 6.3 seconds. Unsurprisingly, It's a hushed mechanical unit, erring tubing raspiness as an alternative to screaming for mercy after you press on harder. Pedal power for second generation SQ5. While the very first SQ5 employed a diesel engine, this occasion it shares a similar 3.0-liter V6 TFSI 354-horsepower power plant with all the related A4 and S5 models. There's 500 Nm of torque on tap from 1,370 revolutions per minute to 4,500 revolutions per minute, enough for the 0.62 mph use of 5.4 seconds. Top speed is electronically tied to 155 miles per hour, no S-tronic twin-clutch gearbox here. The SQ5 uses an 8-speed Tiptronic automatic instead to cope with all the extra torque, sending drive to any or all four wheels by using a full-time quattro system. It's undeniably fast in the straight line but never feels particularly dramatic. Rivals such as Mercedes-AMG GLC 43 provide more theater, even though the SQ5 is quite business-like inside the way it gathers pace. The gearbox is a bit Jekyll and Hyde to begin with, sleepy in their responses when set to D and overly keen dropping gears in S. The best middle ground involves while using steering wheel mounted paddles to decide on gears for yourself, and in this particular mode the SQ5 is rewarding to push. Future Q5 engine options. During 2017, a 3.0-liter V6 TDI will augment the diesel offering, complete using a Tiptronic fully automatic gearbox and permanent quattro four-wheel drive. There's possible that a set of lower-powered 2.0-liter TDIs can also make it towards the UK. In the end, the 150-horsepower edition also available, which has a manual gearbox and front-wheel drive. However, these aren't component of any immediate plan. Audi remains tight-lipped regarding the prospect of whether plug-in hybrid or full-electric e-tron version in a Q5. But we all do expect a racier RSQ5 with this model's life cycle. Handling is quite competent and not exactly fun. Ride quality with optional air suspension impresses. Two modes for off-roading boost the Q5's appeal. You won't choose an Audi Q5 since it offers essentially the most thrilling driving experience in sight segment. Nonetheless, its handling characteristics are well balanced and conducive to creating brisk progress in comfort. There's one significant caveat here: all in the Q5s we've driven to date have been fitted with all the excellent, but optional, adaptive air suspension system. Models fitted with standard steel springs and conventional dampers, in addition to adaptive ones, is going to be sampled on poorly surfaced UK roads, as will the high-performance SQ5. Audi Drive Select is standard through the range, allowing various aspects with the Q5's handling parameters, throttle response, transmission shift pattern and steering response for being varied or mixed based on personal preferences. Steering's an area Audi's had to endure criticism inside the past, but this Q5, along using the A4 and A5 ranges it shares its underpinnings with, attended on significantly. There's an enhanced a higher level feel throughout the wheel itself, more so whenever you switch to dynamic mode, although we'd have liked a little more weight in this particular setting. The ride height of the oxygen suspension is usually controlled through the Drive Select system by toggling between its different modes. Most helps keep it in auto for your majority with the time, but comfort's an excellent option for traversing poorly surfaced asphalt or applying motorways with no trouble, isolating you further in the outside world. It still feels controlled and composed, though, not suffering with exactly the same degree of floatiness you'll experience inside a similarly equipped Mercedes G-Class. Dynamic mode sharpens the Q5's responses, reining in body roll that bit further, yet while it's immediately firmer, it's not jarringly so. Sharper ruts still believe that their edges happen to be rounded off. Flicking to the mode also lowers your vehicle by 15 millimeters. If you're going to venture from the beaten path together with your Q5, then your Outroad boosts the ride height by 25 mm and off-road an additional 20 mm higher modes could possibly get plenty of use, increasing ground clearance for making traversing trickier terrain something that you can do confidently. In these modes the ride quality isn't as soft but feeling those extra bumps and crevices keeps you more attuned to your surface conditions. Sportier S Q5 tightens up handling. The fastest Q5 available, the SQ5 offers a remarkable handling and road holding for any car this size, harking back to a large hot hatch. Grip levels are huge using the Quattro system clinging to the tarmac with neck straining ability, and body roll is kept well in balance providing you find the dynamic drive mode. The only complaint really is while using steering overly light and lacking feel, doesn't necessarily inspire confidence such as the setup in more driver-focused cars much like the Porsche Macan. As a consequence the SQ5's best performance is done that has a little performance located in reserve, as an alternative to being driven at 10/10. As such it makes to get a superb Grand Tourer. Beautifully made cabin. Feels special in any other case innovative. Few blind spots, excellent visibility. With the marque's wholly justified reputation for that supreme quality of their interiors, there's no surprise the Audi Q5's cabin is definitely an exquisite setup which to shell out time. Like the Q5's exterior, its passenger compartment doesn't stray from Audi conventions when it comes to how it looks. Here it feels as though there's a fusion of A4 and Q7 taking, and that's no a dangerous thing. Plastics from the upper reaches from the dashboard have a very satisfyingly deep level of squidginess, while it is all totally assembled basic accuracy and dealing to incredibly tight tolerances, that it appears like it will last for a long time and still be competitive with it was on day one. Expensive feeling switch gear feels delightful to work with and is beautifully weighted, reinforcing the Q5's premium positioning, although we remain unconvinced regarding the multimedia display that now stands proud on the dashboard with a permanent basis, as opposed to be ensconced within its domain or glide effortlessly away from sight it uses very little. Audi's not the initial to take advantage of this tactic also it cites a buyer preference for having these table taping screens on show all in the time. Should you wish to create your Q5's cabin feel all the more special you may push the boat out financially and opt for your 12.3-inch virtual cockpit, a configurable screen that replaces the common instrument cluster, or perhaps the excellent head-up display HUD that projects data on the windscreen. Best to pick one or the opposite, both feels as though overkill. Finding a good driving position is achieved, no matter whether or not leading seats are electrically adjustable, plus the steering adjusts for distance and angle. All-round visibility's decent, too, helped through the Q5's third side windows and slender windscreen pillars. Air suspension improves Q5's comfort. Leather seats and 3-zone climate control. Rear seat would become a squeeze for 3 adults. One aspect how the first generation Audi Q5 majored on was comfort, also it features a lot more prominently second time around. It's worth reiterating that up to now we have only driven the Q5 fitted with all the optional air suspension system, which serve as one in the most cost-setting experiences within this corner from the SUV market. Even from the appropriately titled comfort setting, the Q5 remains composed, rarely suffering through the kind of nausea-inducing floatiness that blights the Mercedes GLC when equipped which has a similar type of suspension. Most Q5 buyers are hoped for to choose the S-line trim, detailed with 19-inch wheels. Even with those, in dynamic mode, passengers are incredibly unlikely to complain about being jolted about. As per the course norms, You will discover 5 seat belts inside Q5, although seating a quintet of adults comfortably will become a challenge, especially using the narrower, firmer center rear seat. 4 up there'll be no grumbles, with decent head and legroom plus a fine view out in the elevated seating positions. The seats themselves really feel supportive. All front chairs offer an electrically adjustable lumbar support, while standard leather trim definitely makes the cabin believe a bit more special. Only S-line versions have rear privacy glass and acoustic side windows to limit exterior noise entering the cabin as part with the standard package. 3's own climate control features along the lineup, enhancing comfort that bit further. Wind noise is low, but some kinds of road surface do amplify the tire roar, although it's effectively drowned out whenever you turn on the sound system. 4 trim levels like the SQ5. All are generously equipped. Extensive and expensive options. The familiar specifications of say, Sport and S-Line were joined right after launch from the sporty SQ5. Standard Audi Q5 SUV equipment. If you recall the days when say, for special equipment, was the pinnacle on the trim hierarchy, it's time for it to get using the times. Here it denotes the entry point to Q5 ownership. Audi doesn't expect many buyers to go just for this trim. Survey the outside and you'll see the 18-inch 5 twin spoke alloy wheels, xenon headlamps with LED daytime running lights, and full LEDs on the rear. Grills and trim facets are black, either matte or glossy dependent upon their location, contrasting while using aluminium roof rails. Once aboard you'll see the leather upholstery, heated front seats, 3's own climate control and aluminium trim inlays for that dashboard and door panels. The rear seats put into 3 parts in a very 40 hours 20 minutes 40 seconds configuration for further flexibility, whilst the tailgate is electrically operated. Many from the Q5's controls are operated from a better MMI multimedia interface system, displaying on the 7.0-inch color monitor. There's no saying of but it is possible to connect your smartphone using Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, while Bluetooth connectivity, a set of USB points and SD card watchers along with an aux in point supplement the CD player, a rarity on contemporary cars. DAB radio and 10 speakers complete the infotainment package. Driving the C-grade Q5 you'll be competent to take advantage in the cruise control, parking sensors, autonomous emergency braking, keyless starting, a power parking brake and comfort biased suspension. Audi's Drive Select system also lets you vary the parameters from the engine's responsiveness, automatic gearbox shifts and climate control effectiveness. If you decide upon the middle or Anken Sport, the differences are surprisingly few. The alloy wheels remain 18 inches, however they are now of an 5 arm star design, even though the grille inserts are finished in twilight gray. Moving on the cabin, the conventional front seats are already exchanged to get a sportier pair with electric lumbar adjustment, as the interior is bathed in ambient LED lighting. There are 2 upgrades to the MMI system, 2, Satinov and Audi Connect, that enables access to a variety of online services. Next up within the Q5 range, and required to account for almost 2/3 of sales, is S-Line, that is even sportier than Sport, and demonstrate it's fitted with 19-inch 5 twin-spoke star alloys, beefed up model-specific bumpers and body kit, together with darkened privacy glass for the rearmost windows. Expect the ride to become firmer though the handling more agile thanks for the firmer rest sports suspension. The headlights are already upgraded to full LED units, even though the rear ones are hallmarked by dynamic indicators, the beam of amber light pulsates outwards with each flash. There's a smattering of S logos from the cabin, including ones embossed on the leather and Alcantara sports seats, even though the sportier controls and gear lever are trimmed in perforated leather. Topping the lineup would be the performance-focused SQ5. It looks very similar to your S-Line but is differentiated by 20-inch versions of precisely the same alloy wheel design, electrically adjustable seats with fine Nappa leather upholstery, along with the upgraded MMI Navigation Plus multimedia system. Optional Audi Q5 SUV accessories. 11 metallic and pearlescent paint finishes supplement the two standard choices, with the array of alloy wheels around 21-inch diameter permit greater personalization. We're currently running in S-Line spec Audi Q5 long-termer. Watch about some with the optional extras you are able to choose from, here. Two suspension option is listed. The adaptive comfort system provides for a penetration of control to vary the firmness while using Audi Drive Select, but for a lot more control, comfort and enhanced off-roading capability, a lot more expensive adaptive air suspension gets our vote. Usefully, Audi has bundled quite a few key options into packs, although lots of the component parts are made available as individual options to suit varying budgets. Adaptive Cruise Control Plus Pack, Distance Regulation Cruise Control is joined by Predictive Efficiency Assistant, which uses SatNav data to advise the motorist on how being more efficient, as well as match the area speed limits automatically. There are also two anti-collision technologies built into the system. Comfort and Sound Pack, Electrically Adjustable Front Seats, Keyless Entry, Hands-free tailgate as well as an upgraded Bang & Olufsen speakers. Light and Vision Pack, the 12.3-inch virtual cockpit is joined by an increased a higher-level interior LED lighting, with 30 hues out there, and LED matrix headlights which band sections of light allowing main beams to be partially on without dazzling oncoming drivers. Parking Assistance Pack. 360-degree camera positions are supplemented by a mechanical self-parking function. Parking Assistance Pack Advanced, because its name suggests it builds upon the aforementioned pack with blind spot warnings, a rear cross-traffic aware of war and the driving force of oncoming traffic when reversing away from a space and exit warning to advise occupants of oncoming traffic before they open a door. Technology Pack. Enhanced MMI system with 8.3-inch display, 10GB disk drive for music storage, DVD player and wireless smartphone charging for compatible devices. Vision Pack, fully digitized 12.3-inch instrument binnacle, a head-up display HUD system to project key information on top of the windscreen and automatic main beam function. 5 stars when crash tested by Euro NCAP. All have partial LED lighting and all-wheel drive. So much remains within the options list, though. As expected, the crash testing experts at Euro NCAP awarded the Audi Q5 the full 5-star safety score when that it was assessed. Among the protection highlights, every Q5 advantages of are LED day or running lights and tail lamps, part-time quattro all-wheel drive full-time for the SQ5. Cruise control, autonomous emergency braking, a pop-up bonnet for enhanced pedestrian protection, automatic lights and wipers, 2 ice-fix child C8 mounting points inside rear seats and 6 airbags. What we're disappointed about is when much in the plethora of leading-edge safety equipment remains on any additional cost options list. Although S-Line and SQ5 versions have full LED headlamps, Audi's matrix LED units are extras on all models. These ones power down portions of light in an attempt to not dazzle oncoming cars if your main beam is fired up. It's worth noting that automatic main beam lighting is additionally extra. Similarly, Audi's excellent head-up display system that projects key information for instance speed and SatNav directions on top of the windscreen is usually optional. Fancy adaptive cruise control, a 360-degree camera, blind spot warning, Cross-traffic attentive to advise you of oncoming vehicles when reversing outside of a space, as well as a clever system certainly wherein warning light flashes should you're on the verge of open a door with cars approaching from behind? Well, each of them cost extra, too. If you're investing in a new Q5 and possess funds to waste on options, think carefully about whether you may need those larger alloy wheels or perhaps upgraded speakers over something that helps keep you and your passengers safer. Not essentially the most spacious, but on par with rivals. Electric tailgate adds further convenience. Would you risk ruining the lovely interior? Despite the premium finish and price with the Q5, buyers of your family-sized SUV still expect a sensible, a higher-level practicality. Sensible is what they get, too, for that Audi doesn't set new standards in capaciousness. Rear seats up, the 550-liter cargo volume is on par with all the BMW X3 and Mercedes-Benz GLC, though them folded over it's 50 liters shy of these 1,600-liter capacity. Land Rover's Discovery Sport rules the roost here with as much as 1,698 liters. Still, it's beneficial, and you also do have an added bonuses of both an electric-operated tailgate along with a rear seat that split folds inside a 40 hours 20 minutes 40 seconds arrangement, allowing long, slender loads to become accommodated along with carrying four passengers comfortably. If you order your Q5 while using optional air suspension, a bonus in the system is that this rear with the car is usually lowered by 55 mm to support the loading of heavier items. Poke throughout the passenger compartment so you'll choose the usual blend of lidded cubbies, door bins, cup holders along with a usefully sized glove box, all nestled into those high-grade interior plastics.